Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brad, and welcome back to Screamin' Pirate EDC. Today we're going to do something I have not done on the channel before, which is a long-term review on multiple knives. Now, part of the reason I'm doing this is some of these knives have come in over the last year, give or take, and they either got unboxings or, you know, initial impressions, but they never got a full review. This is going to be me telling you why they've stuck around in the collection and one that is not. So let's go ahead and get into it. All right, guys. So typically I don't do top downs anymore, but I figured there are four knives here and there are going to be a lot of comparisons and it's more efficient for your time and mine. So, first up, we're going to be looking at the Shirogaev F95RNL, and this is Mars Valley carbon fiber on it. Then it's going to be the Brown Knives FSD. After that, it's going to be the Arno Bernard iMamba, and this is a warthog tusk inlay. And lastly, the Koenig Mini Goblin. Well, let me go ahead and tuck these guys up here. And let's get to talking about the Shiro. So I'm gonna have some stats come up on the screen while I am talking about this knife. So this was actually my very first Shirogaev, and I had to have this red Mars Valley when I saw it. I got a good deal on the aftermarket. I actually paid, I think, $9 for this one, and these are right around $1,100 new. 3.75 inch blade, it just fits my hand, guys. That's the biggest thing. It just fits my hand, and that action is some buttery smoothness. This is an impressive knife. If you are looking for a Shiro and you're okay with a little bit bigger 3.75, I can't recommend this highly enough. I really do like this. But let me go ahead and grab a scale so you guys can generally understand weight on these. Oh man, that glare is something terrible, isn't it, guys? There you go, 4.79, they say 4.75. Let's cut him a little bit of 0.04 slack there. Go ahead and turn him off. And let's do some size comparisons for you guys. So first up, I figured the one that a few that would make a few sense to you guys, this, right? The Trevor Berger LEXK. Now there you go. Kind of a bolster to bolster there, guys. Very similar in hand. So you go on the Trevor Berger, right? And then the Shiro. Obviously a little bit more handle size on the Shiro, but I do really like both. After that, I figured one that is in the similar price range is going to be the Oz Machine Roosevelt. Now, obviously this is a smaller knife, but at a similar price point, around 1,000, give or take, guys. And then finally, the Koenig Arius. So this is obviously an all black DLC one, right? So costs a little bit more, and I figure a lot of people know the Arius. So there is your general size. If you like the Arius, I think you'll like the Shiro, in my opinion. But all that is to say, here it is next to the FSD. FSD is very similar in size, and that's partly why both of them have stayed, because I kind of like the size. But one of them is staying and one of them is leaving, I'll be honest with you guys. As the Shiro stands, I don't really feel like I need another Shiro, which, I mean, says a lot about this one in particular. So, guys, let's go ahead and tuck the Shiro out of the way and move on to the FSD, okay? So, for the FSD, I was trying to figure out what to compare it to, which is a little bit hard sometimes. But I figured the most apropos one had to be another Brown Knives. This is the Cortex. Now, in my initial impressions, I said I wish it was Cortex size. I stand by that. Because this knife, I think, just a bit too big. I wish it was this size, but just keep everything else. I stand by that notion, but I do love the hollow grind on it. The hand hollow grind is phenomenal. Out of this world good. But my only problem with it is I just don't know where to put my hands, guys. Like, it's just a whole lot of handle. I mean, choked up, look at all that space. It's just a ton. I do love the locking mechanism though. It's like this kind of like, I don't know, leaf spring hybrid button lock. It fires open when you flick, like just fires. And in and out of the pocket is great too, because if you look, there is some flat there, right? So it's very easy in and out of the pocket. Mill job is phenomenal. This one in particular is number, let me see if I can get it, number 9. So direct from Craig. In hand, it's good. It's just, I think it should be Cortex size. With that being said, let's go ahead and do some other size comparisons and weight on this sucker. There you go, 5.13. So outside of the Cortex, I wasn't quite sure what to compare it to. And then, you know, it almost feels like with the mill job and just kind of in general, this is next to a Benchmade Anthem. So overall use, I would say they're about the same use for me. After that, I wanted another larger knife, I'm gonna put it that way. This is going to be a Vero Impulse, okay? Very similar to that Vero Impulse. And then finally, I wanted to do one front flipper since the FSD is a front flipper. This is next to the very popular Pena Bravo. I feel like the Pena Bravo is kind of like the best EDC size in hand. I mean, as you can see there, guys, whereas the FSD is just a little bit big, in my opinion. Well, let's go ahead and tuck all of that out of the way and move on to the next knife. So next up, we have the iMamba. I was really excited about this knife because a lot of people said that it was basically a medium Chris Reeve. And you know what, guys? They weren't wrong. Ooh, let me get him out. So this is a large Sebenza 21. Put him right up there. And this is a small 20 or small 31. And as you can see, it's dead in the middle. So let me go ahead and get this really close so you can kind of understand that, guys. So there it is next to a large 21. So it's just a little bit shorter on the blade and the handle. And then here is a small 31. So just a little bit bigger. It's literally dead centered and I kind of love it for that. It sits in the hand very nicely. My one big complaint about this knife is they are loose bearings. So taking this apart kind of sucks. But as you just saw, reverse flick and flipper. So yeah, I do like that. And it is very comfortable in hand. Well, now that you've seen it between the two there, the other one I wanted to show you guys is going to be, here we go, Mac 2 3.5. If you like a Mac 2 3.5, you're probably gonna like the iMamba. Okay. The one other one I wanted to compare for you guys is going to be the Trevor Burger, since they're both South African knives. Again, very, very similar. If you like that size blade, the iMamba is great. So far, I have been very pleased with it. It cuts well. It has been performing for me just fine. And yeah, very smooth because of those loose bearings. But being able to reverse flick, that's pretty cool. All right, so let's go ahead and tuck him up here and move on to the Mini Goblin. So this Mini Goblin in particular has been customized by Cap City Creations. You can see there's a light bark texture there. So that is the one thing that is unique about this one. In hand though, it is everything people says it is. This bump does not bother me at all. It being flipper only doesn't bother me because the detent is perfect. Really do like that. I almost forgot, guys, I didn't get weight on the iMamba. I do apologize. So let me go ahead and bring that up. There you go, 4.06. And then let's do the Mini Goblin since I already have the scale out. So it's gonna be 3.7 on the nose. Now, for the Mini Goblin, you know, a lot of people are not gonna like this hump here, but I think it's well chamfered enough that it just doesn't bother me. Also, the hollow grind on this is absolutely killer. It is slicey. And the action is just killer. It's everything you want it to be. But let's go ahead and do some size comparisons because kind of a hard knife to pin down if you've never had one. Here it is next to an Oz Roosevelt. They're actually very similar in size. Very similar, actually. So if you have a mini goblin and you've been hunting a Rosie, I say go for it, okay? But also vice versa, all right? I really like this size knife, especially when it's compact like this. Next up, let's do a couple other sheep's foot slash warnings. Here is an AD 20.5, okay? General size there, a little bit bigger on the 20.5. After that, let's do the F5.5. This is a very popular, one of my favorite under $200 knives. Very similar overall. And then finally, one of the coolest warnings out there in existence outside of the mini goblin has to be the Arcane Crawler. Arcane Design Crawler, guys. There you go. As far as the mini goblin, I think the mini goblin is definitely going to be a keeper for me. And a lot of that is the detent is just perfect. It's just perfect. I never have a problem deploying it. I can't middle finger flick it or anything like that, but if a deployment is apt, the detent is actually perfect, guys, for deployment. It just doesn't matter how you hold it. It just fires. Also, I love hollow grinds, guys. What can I say? You know, hollow be thy grind, guys. But this one is killer just because of the extra customization as well. Well, guys, with all that being said, you've now seen a few size comparisons for these four knives and kind of my general thoughts on them. But with that being said, which one is going to stay and which one is going to go? You can probably already guess which one is leaving, but let's go ahead and head back up top for my final conclusions. All right, so we did a little bit of size comparisons, had some specs up on the page, and told you why some of these knives are sticking around. But as a final conclusion for you guys, what we're gonna do is which ones are actually sticking around. So, first up is gonna be the Shiro. The Shiro is definitely a plunder. It is my only Shiro, and it's honestly, guys, it's the only Shiro I want. The action's great, it fits my hand, I really do like it. Next up is going to be the FSD from Brown Knives. Now, shocking to me, especially after, you know, I fidgeted with this knife, I can't tell you how often, I'm gonna let it go. Part of the reason is it just doesn't get the pocket time I thought it would, and it's a bit big for what I would say is the ergonomics. I just feel like there's just so much real estate, guys. It's more than I know what to do with, and yeah, it just doesn't get the pocket time. After that is gonna be the Arno Bernard iMamba. So the iMamba is gonna be a plunder. So the FSD is a plank, the iMamba is gonna be a plunder, guys. Partly because it's what I always wanted in a Chris Reeve. It's a bearing medium size Sabenza. It's what I've wanted for a long time, and it's very well done. So the last one is going to be the Mini Goblin. Guys, this one is an absolute blunder for me. The over the top is definitely the bark texture, but I think what really, really sold the Mini Goblin for me was at Blade Show when Bill Koenig got this knife in hand and went, man, I hate custom work like this. This is really damn good. So this is Bill Koenig approved. So this one's sticking around. Well, guys, go ahead, like, comment, and subscribe. Hopefully this was helpful to you, and I'll catch you on the next one.